Hi, in this tutorial I would like to show you the new visualization capability in perClass Mira. It allows us to summarize or visualize the content of our spectral cubes in more sophisticated way using different spectral indices on common equations. I loaded a project where we can see in each scan a plant, a potato plant. This is a control plant, so it's a healthy plant. But we also have plants with a disease. If we look through different bands, it's not so apparent to us, but if we switch to a color preview, you can see that some of the leaves are healthy and others are really affected by the disease. If we want to visualize the content of the spectral cube in some specific way, we can use the new visualization tool that is here in the toolbar. And you see that there is a visualization panel that I placed on top of the spectral plot. I place it there because for each visualization equation we have some parameters. So in this case I only have a single parameter, which is basically a range from 633 nanometers to 666 nanometers, and that is actually visualized also as this rectangle in the spectral view, which I can drag, of course, where I like. And now the visualization of the cube is showing the integration for each pixel, integration of values in this spectral range. You can see the value at the status bar of the window. So we can of course look at different equations, such as the ratio between two bands, and that is more interesting for us. We are interested in this area where healthy plants, healthy leaves will show its characteristic dip, and this area in near infrared where we see more flat. So you can see basically the ratio related to the chlorophyll content. Now if we look in our image, we can see some distinction between healthy leaves and infected leaves. However, because the visualization is applied to the entire image, our plant pot or box is actually having a much higher value, and that's not interesting for us. What we can do in perClass Mira is to define a classifier, and we can use this information for focusing our analysis. We already did this. We created classes such as background, leaves, stem, and plastic label, and built a classifier that can segment out our plant from the background. So that's a nice first step. If we switch back to the visualization, we can actually flag some of these classes as foreground, and in this way focus our analysis visualization only to the respective pixels. So now we do not have any disturbing background objects, and our auto-scaling of visualization output is applied only to the interesting pixels of the plant. If we look at different images, you can see that the auto-scaling is actually changing the minimum and maximum values. Now it is only computed on the pixels of foreground. However, we would like to have comparable results on different images, and that's why we want to switch off this auto-scaling. We can simply do it by adjusting the range on both ends. What will happen is that we will also start seeing pixels that have a value below the current minimum, or other way around, pixels that have value above the current maximum. So this will allow us to visualize a good range. And then if we apply this visualization to different images, we will get exactly the same stretch and the range of values. We can also change the color map and by that maybe highlight different information that we are interested in. If we look at these different equations, you can also get equations related to NDVI indices or equations that use up to four parameters. Note that the parameters are defined in nanometers but translated into bands available from our sensor. That means that we can also end up with a definition that has zero bands, like my parameter 2, and then everything would be rendered as invalid in red. For some type of equations, you may of course see invalid pixels as well, specific invalid pixels that are related, for example, to not a number value of the calculation. If you define a visualization that you are interested in and you fine-tune it so that it's saying what you want, you may select multiple images and export these visualizations as images, for example, for your reporting. So in this tutorial, we have quickly looked at new functionality where we can perform calculations on the content of spectral cubes with common equations and visualize the results only for the objects of interest. Thank you for your attention.